This video will cover the entire process from beginning to end of creating an interior mood board entirely on your iPad, so that by the end of this video, you will have a clear roadmap on how to draw like this. And hi, I'm Anna. I've coached thousands of creatives just like you to bring their ideas to life in a unique, artistic, and most importantly, fast way. So now let's dive into the design process. The app I use is called Procreate, and once again, you don't need anything else. Here's what I did first. I selected the furniture and decor items I liked and defined the overall composition for the mood board. And by the way, before we dive into the drawing and design process, here's something important to mention. This mood board is actually part of my process of dreaming big and building an ambitious strategy for what my dream collaboration with one of my favorite brands, Vitrick, would look like. So the mood board, you'll be seeing this video, is my imaginary collaboration with Vitra, as if they asked me to design and draw a calendar for them. And by the way, at the end of this video, I'll also share why it's so important to act and live your life as if you're already there, because that mindset can literally change everything. Now let's go. So I'm currently on the Vitra website, and I think I just found the first furniture item for my calendar. Guess the month I'll be using this chair for. Of course, February, because of the Valentine's Day, and the shape suits us perfectly. Let's adjust the color. I'd like to go with dark orange. And congratulations to us, the first item is ready to go, so to speak. And before moving on to the rest of the calendar, let me show you this hand-drawn sketch I created on my iPad. Yes, this is a digital sketch, which I then printed out using some printing services. If you'd like to know which printing services exactly, please let me know in the comments. I'm going to leave the link down below because I don't remember the name. Let me show you the digital version of this collage. Here it is. I created it completely from scratch. First, I started with quick draft lines in order to define the overall proportions for my collage. Then I moved on to the neat contours, followed by applying simple marker strokes. Well, basically, here I was using the same principle we're currently using. So first, I kind of created a messy collage consisting of all of those furniture items from the Vitra store, and then I created its hand-drawn version. So I'm super excited to be creating our today's calendar together with you. Yay! And now let's move on to the other months together. Bye-bye. Okay, bye-bye. See you in the next part of this video.
Probably right, and maybe I'm wasting my life. We live in the moment, we light up the night, we roll till the morning. Oh, hey, oh, hey, oh. We bump up the low end, we own paradise. The cool kids are going, oh, hey, oh, hey,
back. And now let's quickly talk about the entire design and drawing process. And please ignore my change of clothes, because I just came back home from the gym and I only have around about 10 minutes, because after that I'm going to pick my dinner. So let's quickly dive into the entire drawing and design process. First of all, the entire process started by picking all of the furniture items which I wanted to use for my concept, right? And I used the drag and drop feature in the Procreate app because this is the app that I was working in. There is a feature which is called insert. When you click settings, then you click insert, and then you can insert all of your furniture items one by one. And after that, you can also get rid of the white background. And this is how you work with interior design mood boards. Of course, on this channel, you'll find plenty of tutorials on how to design in the Procreate app, so make sure to check it out. And by the way, if you're new to iPad design and you'd like to start designing and drawing like me, you're in the right place because I wrote an entire guide for you. It's free on how to choose the right iPad, how to pick the right brushes, and of course, I listed all of my custom brushes inside that guide too. It can be found in the description below the video. Make sure to check it out. Make sure to download it because it's a treasure trove when it comes to digital drawing and design. Now, when it comes to the drawing process, there I only used three brushes, and that's all. First, I started with quick draft lines in order to define the overall proportions, but since I already had my collage, that step was like more to define the proportions of all of those furniture items, like separately. After that, I decreased the opacity of that layer and moved on to the neat underlines, followed by applying quick marker strokes. Basically, I was imitating paper sketching. Well, this is not the right example to show you because it's also a digital sketch which was printed out. I also mentioned that somewhere at the beginning of the video, right? But this is the idea, like, basically, you use a couple of pens too, a couple of marker strokes, and your quick idea is done. So, once again, this is the final collage. Make sure to share your opinions on that. And now, let me quickly share kind of an idea of why I'm doing all this. First of all, don't forget that you all are part of my And She Draws Big world. When I was searching for a name for my brand, I had a couple of criterias which I wanted to follow. First of all, I didn't want my name to sound average, like annasdesign.com, annasdrawings.com. No, I didn't want to sound like anybody else. And that's why, this is, by the way, a hack for you and how you can pick a name for your brand too. It was like back in 2018 or something like that, and I was still an interior design student, like thinking big, even like still studying all of those things. So first of all, I defined the logic and the values I have in my life, what I want to achieve, how I want my work to be, you know, which kinds of dreams do I have in regards of career. And that included big, ambitious, being bold, and all of these things. And this is how I came up with the word big, like very extraordinary story, Anna, bravo. But anyway, then how I came up with the rest. Well, at that time, I was really enjoying drawing mostly because during my interior design studies, I avoided computer renderings at all costs because, to be honest, I find them super boring, flat, inflexible, and lifeless. And I mentioned that pretty often, so there is a possibility that you might be hearing this in one of my future videos on YouTube, but it doesn't matter. And if you, by the way, if you can relate to that and you also hate computer renders or you're searching for an alternative to them, well, then I have fantastic news for you because I have an online 3D drawing academy where exactly I teach you how to draw like me on your iPad using the Procreate app so that you have stunning designs like these. And yes, you can draw like this too. Just look at the results of my students. Again, all of the links can be found in the description below the video. And now back to how to find a name for your brand. So then I was a fan of God, this is such a crazy story. Okay, back then I was a fan of the clothing brand, which is called And Other Stories. And I really liked that beginning, and, you know, And Other Stories. So it's not like other stories, but it's and other stories, like symbolizing that there is something else going on, right? And I wanted to emphasize the importance of my brand being limitless, being bold without any boundaries, and that and literally symbolizes that. So now you have the full story, like almost behind the name of that. So the thing is that when you're truly passionate about what you do, you believe in it, and you truly know that your ideas are going to change the world, you have to shout about them from the mountaintop. Because otherwise, how else people are going to find you? And now I'm going to share a couple of examples from my own story, and you'll see that hiding your things and hoping that someone will find you, this is not the right way. So basically, during my interior design studies, shortly before that, I was drawing a lot, every single day, multiple drawings. But the thing is that back then, I didn't really know that marketing is way more important than my skills per se. And that's why I was hoping to reach that perfection. Maybe tomorrow, maybe 1 month, but till then, I'm not going to be sharing anything. And this is how I lost, I don't know, 5+ years or something like that. Till one day I started diving into marketing, till one day I decided to be bold, till one day I decided to stop. This is something that we don't study at universities or at art school, for instance. I also studied at art school, and many of my watercolor drawings were often classified as one of the worst in the group. And this kind of support I was receiving back then. And can you imagine, like, me being traumatized as an 11-year-old kid, basically. But then there was the opposite teacher, thank God, who was supporting me in my lines, hatching, shadowing. Guess what? This is my characteristic style. Well, what a surprise. See how crucial it is to find the right support. And this is why I'll be so happy to be your own mentor, because in my academy, I'll be supporting you and pointing you and finding your strengths, not your weaknesses. Because to be honest, there are no weaknesses in art. And here's the thing about marketing. It doesn't matter which kind of drawing you basically produce. Of course, you should still, you know, learn the foundations and then kind of adapt your composition styles and all of these things. But basically, the first thing you need to know is to how to market yourself properly, how to shout about your services from the mountaintop. And this is exactly what I'm doing with my videos. Like, I enjoy it. I believe in my work. I believe in my stories. I believe in everything I do. Why not? So let it be this lesson for you from this video. Why not shout it from the mountaintop? And now I have to pick my dinner. Bye-bye, everyone. See you in the next video.